Sorry, it scratched. So if something happened with this kind of technology, I'm very sorry. So we will back to the very beginning, but when you sit on chairs, okay? I'm deeply sorry. These things sometimes may happen when we don't want it. We start from where we were, okay? At the same place, okay? So, please, 1 minute. It's up to you. No. It's new technology, you know, it's the way we live. Okay, guys, sorry. Thank you.
of the concert, I think we'd like to maybe say a few words about what you've seen for the 5 days, should I say 5 days. Thank you very much, Christoph, for a wonderful performance.
To memorize how to move and how to, that sounds actually really come from the heart, not just the instrument. So thank you, I learned a lot from you as well. So thank you very, very much. And of course, the man standing next to me here is Peter Will, and it's been exactly 10 years, right? Like since our first collaboration with Studio Music Fabrique. Okay, my microphone's open. So it's 10 years.
10 years.
10 years that we've been collaborating with composers and musicians from Malaysia and Singapore. And at that time, we were having a little bit of tour between Singapore, Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur, and Thailand. And wow, okay, the follower, now I know how Christopher might have felt.
Exactly.
So, and this is the first time that we actually really get a lot of musicians to work in small groups. Normally we have a whole ensemble, you conducting, and a member of PGIM sort of like working within the group. But this time is the first time that we get them to...
Exactly.
Kind of like, yeah,
I wanted to mention that too, that I think that's actually been a very special part of this whole week, is to see how the musicians, how quickly they got together. Yeah. They had an initial contact via Zoom, already before we came, which I think was quite important, just the thought of having already met a little bit. And then as soon as the collaboration started, I must say that the learning curve was very, very steep upwards at a very rapid rate.
And this is kind of like a proof that technology can really help in not only to make music, but to also make friendship between musicians from different continents. I remember that we were using messengers, WhatsApp, Zoom, or even telephone calls to get them together. And this has been, I think, a huge learning curve for us as the as a conductor, as the organizer of the event as well, that maybe we can leave it onto our younger friends' hand.
Exactly. Well, it's kind of both, isn't it? It's also showing us that there's nothing that can replace being physically together, because the years that we had to wait where we couldn't be together again were extremely frustrating, but we found amazing ways via Zoom, also last year, the whole festival, but it's been such a revelation this time to make it happen again. And as I say, these small combinations of musicians, I think we should keep for the future, because I think it's been highly successful.
And I think we were thinking, even in terms of logistic, in a way that we have all these small pieces. If anything happened, we can just shuffle the program around, as you can see today. Some of them, but nothing happened, by the way. Okay.
Yeah.
So, could you tell us a little bit about like how you choose the program? You can see that there are small program by Studio Music Fabrique and also Music Hochschule Lübeck that has been spread around, like this so-called like symposium festival type of thing. Can you? How did you choose all those pieces?
Yes,
we kind of cook it together many, many times, right?
A lot of the initiatives came from the musicians themselves. Some of the suggestions, of course, came from us because of in Ensemble Musique Fabrique, we had the experience last year that when we were allowed to suddenly play together in very small groups, we put on about 4 concerts a week. For a very small audience that we played twice and could only have 2 or 3 musicians. So we quickly were searching through our whole repertoire and looking for new repertoire for that. So a little bit of that knowledge was able to flow into this as well, which was great. But many of the suggestions also came from the musicians themselves, which I think is also wonderful.
And I think this completely changed the way how we think of symposium or festival or concert, because it's really a co-curator It's a co-curated program, actually all the way through, that all of our wonderful speakers, wonderful keynote and performers here, they actually kind of like suggested what kind of piece that they want to do, and we sort of work together in tying it together. So it's really kind of revealing in a way. It sounds like they're ready. I think we're almost done our improvisation here.
I think they're done.
Next piece, I think you have to tell us a little bit, Those Were the Days by Dieter Marc. I know that he was kind of writing it in memories of his past. Can
That's
you share
right.
us a little bit?
Dieter Marc likes to talk about his past where he was in a rock band. That's part of Dieter that many people don't know about. I mean, those who have been here often at AYE will have heard the big band under Dieter Marc, but that he was actually in a rock band, many people don't know. So this is a most interesting piece where those who know his music will unrecognizably know that's Dieter Marc, but they will hear aspects of it which they have not heard in his music before.
Yeah. And he mentioned actually on Monday that he will be appropriating himself in the piece as well. So you will hear, he mentioned something like Franz Zappa, Weatherman, and many, many other things, and also some of his earlier piece as well. And he's just wrote this like in 2021, which is only 1 year, and it has been play in his hometown in Speyer, right? So there are a lot of things, and I can't think of any better piece to end the concert, the final concert of PGYS, than Those Were the Days by Dieter Marc.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
The last sound of PGM International Symposium 2022. We are very much looking forward to welcome you next year. But before that, I'd like to say a big thank you to everyone here. Thank you for bringing a wonderful music, a wonderful sound, wonderful stories, and wonderful ideas to Princess Kalayaan Institute of Music. music. So thank you all, and hopefully that we can continue all these conversations, not just today, but over another year until 23rd of August 2023. So mark the date, and we hope to see you again next year. So the date is set. So I think this is our tradition that we should take all pictures together. Now, whoever survived the fifth day, please join us on the stage. And for you, those of you who are watching from live, Facebook Live, please also check out other performances as well for our festival, for our international symposium. Or check our website, pgas.pgam.ac.th. You should be able to see an archive of not only just this year, but many, many years. And next year, behold, it's going to be our 10th year. So let's see what kind of things we're going to come up with. It. So have a good night. And for those who are watching online, and for those who are in the hall, come up and take a picture together. Thank you from PGAM.